Hello there, Ray here, and today I'd like to show you guys a brand new villager breeder for 1.14. Just in this snapshot, they went ahead and fixed it so that villager breeders are now possible again, but because of the 1.14 changes, they have completely changed as well. I'll be going over all the changes to the villager breeders and showing you this design that allows you to make large amounts of villagers relatively easy, so that you can get back to doing your villager trading and get tons and tons of great loot. We did a lot of this testing during our snapshot stream, and it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed testing stuff out with you guys. And if you would like to take part in those, they are Wednesday and Friday nights at 9 p.m. Eastern Time. This is a new villager breeder design that I came up with. You notice it has a lot of features very similar to my previous design, but with changes to 1.14, you can see there's also some differences as well. So what we got the pairs of villagers inside of their cells. They're sitting on top of a post, which puts them up a little bit higher. And we have each pair in their own cell, and they're spaced out, so they won't be throwing food at each other. Up on top, we have beds. So for the villagers to breed, they need to have at least 3 beds to consistently breed. You can place down like 2 beds, and they'll breed. But if you want them to consistently breed, you want to have 3 beds per pair. So we have here is a bed here, a here, and here. And these 3 beds are going to these 2 villagers. And then these 3 beds over here are going to these villagers. And then these 3 beds over here are going to these villagers over here. And you can see they're giving hearts because they want to breed. And when they come up showing the little angry villager symbols, it means that they're having problems, which normally has to do with them not finding their bed. So you can see how these guys are putting off hearts, and then these little angry symbols are coming above them. Now the villagers do not need a workstation, they don't need to sleep in their beds, and they don't need like a bale either. They do need to be close enough so that they can find their beds, and if you put the beds down lower, they'll try to sleep in them, and then when they get out of the beds, they can end up in the wrong spot from where they started. Now a big difference you notice in this design compared to the old villager breeders is that the old ones used to have a guy standing way up above all the other breeders, and he was standing by some doors. And the way that used to work is that that villager would see all these doors and say, hey, I need more villagers to occupy all these doors up here with me. And he would shout out to all the villagers around, tell them that they could go ahead and breed to occupy the doors where he was at. So the villagers down below would start breeding and produce plenty of babies, but none of the babies would be within range of the doors, and therefore the villagers down below would constantly keep breeding. If you're not sure what I'm referring to, you can always check out my previous video about villager breeding, which I'll link in the description. Now, we don't need to have any of that in this version. All we need to do is have the pairs of villagers and enough beds. As well, we also need to supply them with food. And they do use up the crops just as they did before. So all you would have to do is hook up a crop farm to this, and the crop farm would just immediately put all this crops directly into your breeder. I have seen quite a few comments asking if the farmers will still do crops. So here we got a crop setup. You see we got some crops that are ready to harvest and some that are empty. And they will harvest the crops and also replant. It doesn't seem like they're always concentrated on the empty spots like they used to in the past, but we will see them harvest these plants. So that guy just harvested this crop here. Let's see if they will replant them. And he did replant it. Now the only difference is it seems like their AI is kind of concentrating on doing their little gossiping as well as going to their meetings and also going to their workstation. So they're kind of splitting that between actually doing farming. So they're definitely not as efficient as in the past, but they will do it. We have the food moving around so the villagers can pick it up. So this is moving right beside the villagers, very similar to my old design, and the villagers are able to pick it up. They can reach anything that is 1 meter away from where their hitbox is at the same Y level as them. So if you put the food like on top of these beds, they won't be able to grab it from up here. It has to be with the same Y level as their hitbox. And the way that I set this up is that we have this one path that can feed both sides. So we can put villagers over here, and we can also put villagers over here. I just use slabs, that way I wouldn't have to put beds down so I could illustrate that it takes 3 beds per pair. But over here we also have some cells with villagers in it, exactly like over there. And even though the potatoes end up on the far side over there, they kind of get aligned on that side, villagers that are standing over here are still able to pick up these potatoes in the water. And then you can continue this pattern, like you could put villagers here as well as here, and they would be able to pick up from this water stream right here. And you can make this as large as you want. Now when the villagers do breed, we have the same kind of setup as my previous farm where they are standing on posts so that the adult villagers will not be able to fall through. The baby villagers are small enough they can fall between the area of this post and this wall over here. Here comes a baby villager. And then I use the same kind of stream as I designed for my previous design where we wash them along. And the way that we extend these water streams is by using this little trick here that I showed in my previous design where you have a water stream here. And then when you want to extend it, you come down and have some cobble walls 1 meter underneath. And this will allow for the babies to move down half meter. And then they got another water current down here that's separate and moves them over. And then they move up and they hop into this water current and they're continued on. That way you can extend these breeders out as far as you want. And then at the end here, what we have is we just collect all the babies from all the different rows and we move them all towards the center and then we drop them downwards. This is really important because the villagers can try to steal beds and that can cause a lot of problems. If the villagers do steal the beds, then the villagers here will put out those little angry symbols that I showed before and they won't be able to breed. So sort of like in the previous design where you had to move the babies far enough away so they didn't count towards the village, in this one you also have to do it. But in this one you have to move them 64 meters away so that they no longer try to steal beds or interfere with what's going on up here. So you can move them horizontally or you can move them vertically. I just went ahead and dug a deep hole that is at least 64 meters deep. And I just let all the villagers fall all the way down here on some slime blocks and have them just sitting here. And you can see these guys are trying to breed, but obviously they don't have enough beds to breed. Now, if you wanted to, you could put your breeder up in the air, and therefore, when you drop them, they could end up at the same level as your ground. It's also good to fill in the gaps between the glass. So if I would leave this block here missing, the villagers, as well as other mobs, will try to pathfind between the corner of blocks, so they would try to pathfind out of here. And by filling this in, they just won't try to pathfind, which will make it a bit less leggy. Now, you don't have to use glass here. You can use stone if you want to. And the beds themselves don't actually do any kind of suffocation to the villagers. So even though this bed is directly inside of his head, you can still see that the actual hitbox of the bed is not interfering with their eyesight either. The red lines underneath of it. That way, they're still able to breed with each other. So if you put a block directly inside of their head, where it would cover up those little red lines, then the villagers would not be able to see each other and would not be able to breed. Now, if you want to, you can put like a slab underneath of the villagers. This is something that Grandma Mommy showed us during our Twitch stream. And what that does, it just prevents them when they do try to throw food, it will kind of capture their food. And that is something that you can do because this villager that is on the far side of the food, so let's say the food is coming in here, and it's getting aligned to the far side, way over there. This villager group that's over here consists of one villager that is close enough to pick it up. He's close enough to pick up the food that's over here. This villager over here is not. And what will happen is that the villagers will actually, when one picks him up, he will actually be able to give it to the other one. But sometimes they don't even like show them giving them food. They just end up with food in their inventory. So I can check this guy. You can see somehow he acquired some potatoes. So maybe he threw potatoes very quickly and I wasn't able to see it. That way the outside villager is able to get food as well. So if you want to prevent the food from falling through, which I've never seen it fall through with these guys. So if you put like the trapdoor slab at this Y level, the babies will be able to be spawned in at the feet of them and they'll be able to fall through. Yet the food won't be able to fall down into where the babies are. Now you can see since I've introduced some new villagers over here, these villagers have went ahead and stole some beds from these guys over here. And that's why these guys are angry. So the most important part about this breeder is to make sure you don't have any villagers that are going to steal away the beds from the other guys. So if you do notice this problem, just go ahead and break some of the beds and replace them. And then they'll eventually find the beds that they want. Now in this water stream here, you can go ahead and not use ice. Since it changed the way that water works, pretty much items move just as fast on waters as it do on ice. But you do need to have some ice when going underneath the spots without any water. So the way you set this up is that you push the villagers in. So you can have villagers a little bit higher like this, and then you can push them in. And once they fall in, they won't be able to get out. And then you can go ahead and remove the scaffolding blocks that you're using. And then you can put in the beds. So these beds will be associated with these villagers right here. And once they're attached to those beds, you can go ahead and add in the next villagers over here. The beds are easy to be placed in. When you place in beds, it's possible to place the top half inside of entities. So I can place it here and I'll place it directly inside of their heads. And the last one goes on top of here. And then we can give food to these guys over here. Now you see those guys are in heart mode and they produce a baby. So now we can put in another set of villagers. And those guys went heart mode and produced a baby as well. It's a really simple and easy design, and it works great. You don't need to have tons of redstone or pistons or anything like that. All the villagers get into their positions, get their food, and the babies are produced. If you would like to look at this in more detail, I will provide the world download down in the description. I really like this design. I'll probably expand on it more in the future. A big thanks to everyone who came out during the stream, especially Grandma Mommy, who did a lot of testing with me to do with figuring out how the villager breeders work. And if you guys would like to be there as we test this stuff, we do have a 1.14 snapshot server, and we will be streaming that this Friday as well. And you can find more information down in the description. Remember, if you found this video interesting, give it a like, and be sure to share it with somebody. And for those who haven't already subscribed, this is a great time. You can now subscribe for free. And if you would like notifications of like when I stream, as well as when videos come out, go ahead and hit that bell button. And I would love to hear what you guys think about these villager breeders. You can tell me all that down in the comments. I'd like to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye!